So at first I had thought about using the iPhone 7 for this experiment, but after much thought, I decided just to go with an old Motorola Razr phone. And as you guys can see here, we started out with some little butane torches. Now these were not putting off the kind of heat that I really expected. I was expecting something more a little grand than this. And these turn out to be glorified cigarette lighters. And not a lot was done. There's some rubber on the back of this phone and I was able to melt down some of the rubber. And you guys could see here, the rubber even caught fire. But really that's about all we could do. And I had to keep reloading these lighters or these burners every minute and a half to 2 minutes. So I had to do something else. This really just wasn't going to work at all. So the idea for this whole experiment was to kind of duplicate Mr. Gear's 1000 degree knife, but with a cell phone. And I was gonna try to cut through something with the cell phone on this Motorola phone. The only metal that it had on the phone was around the edges. So I went to my father-in-law's shop and grabbed his acetylene torch. This is a full-blown blowtorch. And as you guys can see, it was getting much hotter than those other stinking little torches. And as you guys can see here, it melted directly through this Diet Coke bottle with absolutely no trouble at all. You can see my paw-in-law over there kind of running away, trying not to get soaked by this Diet Coke. And so we had kind of had enough of the mess. We saw that we got it hot enough to melt through plastic. Okay, big deal. Just for giggles, since this cell phone is now totally destroyed, we decided to try and cut through it with the blowtorch. And this particular blowtorch had run out of oxygen, so it wasn't getting as hot as it could get. But you guys can see there, the battery has already exploded and torches were flying everywhere. We had just a blast with this. And of course, I couldn't see anything after we finished. Words of the wise, use some kind of visor or something. Don't look directly into the light. And also something that you're not seeing here in the camera is that all sorts of gases were coming out of here. The flame was green at one point, which I thought was really neat. You can't see it in this video, but we torched and torched and torched without the oxygen. It took about 3 or 4 minutes to actually cut through the entire phone, but it was a blast to do it. We had a lot of fun. And at this point, once we got to the center of the phone, things started going crazy. Little components just started sparking up everywhere. And I was actually wearing a pair of flip-flops, which wasn't the best idea. I was like constantly worried that I was gonna burn a hole through my foot. Luckily, there was no damage done. My father-in-law actually had on some Crocs as well. So I was kind of worried about his feet. His feet are actually underneath that metal table, so they were pretty safe. I'm on the other side of the camera holding this thing, so my feet were exposed. Luckily, no damage done to the feet. I can't say, you know, what might have been done to our lungs breathing this stuff. Probably should have had on some kind of ventilator. But as you can see, we're able to cut all the way through the phone. And at this point, he's just trying to melt through the glass. So all the metal and all of the rubber and all of the components inside are totally scorched. Right now, we're just focusing on the glass, trying to melt through that. So after just a couple minutes of torching this thing, it fell apart and it was cut directly in half. So I thought this was really cool. I panned in here to try to get a better view of the inside of the phone. You guys can see here that it is red hot. So I really wanted to show the final damage of the phone, but unfortunately my battery ran out. The end result was actually pretty cool. I wish that I had had more battery. But anyways, guys, that about wraps it up for this video. Be sure to subscribe to the channel for more content like this, hopefully in the future. Thanks for watching. Be blessed. I'll see you in the next one.